Hello, hello, guys. Here we have an answer. Let's see. It's not turning on at all, and there's a big lesson on this machine. You know why? You'll see why I'm saying there's a big lesson on this machine. Here I have okay, whatsoever. Anyway, this is a DC bench power supply. So what you do is you supply the 19 volts here on this machine. I can use any ground anywhere. So you connect one prop to ground because I'm supplying power. Let's see. Okay. Let's put back the keyboard. I'm trying to connect a keyboard here. Ish. Keyboard is not connected, so I will have to do my best to connect the keyboard. Okay. The keyboard has been connected and the 19 volts has been connected. So what you do, the fan is spinning and the machine is taking. Okay, it went off. So there is a light here. I'm sure you can see there's an orange light here. Okay, let's watch, observe. I'm gonna press the power button. Just observe here on an orange light. There should be a blue light. Yeah, I think a blue or green. Okay, it can't be green. I think it's a blue light. Let's go ahead. Let's see. I'm pressing the power button. Okay, it's not working. I hope you can see. Power button is not working. Let's turn off the power supply. Turn it on again. And there is a blue light. The machine turns on and lighting on the screen and then switches off. Okay, when I diagnosed this machine first time, I removed the battery. Okay, let me switch off the power supply. I removed the battery, I removed everything, but the PC was still giving me some issue until I realized that the problem was coming from the keyboard. All right, okay, so now the keyboard has been removed, right? Let's try to turn on the machine. Press the power there. Okay, the laptop is not turning on. So how do you turn on this laptop now without the power button? Because remember here on this machine, the keyboard, it's integrated with a power button, so the power button is within the keyboard. So now how do we turn it on without a keyboard? It's easy. Okay, you turn your meter into a continuity mode and then you connect one prop to ground as always, and then from here, okay, you touch. Okay, there's a last pin of which is ground. You touch the second pin from the ground. Yeah, the machine will turn on. We have a light here and we do have a display. Okay, you know what, let me turn it off. Let's connect the battery because I want to show you everything. I can even remove this. I think there is a battery on this machine. I think the battery is charged. Let's repeat again, one prop to ground and then we charge it there. Okay. Okay, sorry about that. Okay, I believe the power, I mean the battery power is gone. So let's connect this. And then that. Okay, and let me flip it so that you can see a display. Okay, one prop, let's check one prop. Connect one prop to ground. Okay, boo. Now what should we do? Put some power. Okay, the machine is turning on now. There is a light. Okay, it went off. Okay, it's turning on again. You can see right there the light. And I know within some few minutes you will see. Okay, it went off again. Watch, observe here. There's a light and there's a display. Okay, there's no display, but I thought I saw something on the screen. Okay, yeah, there we go. The machine is working 100%. It says no portable device. All right. So the lesson here is okay, let me show you. Let me just switch off everything. Okay guys, let me explain this clean and clear. Okay, the problem with this machine is that the power button is within the keyboard. So that's why with this machine you will always have these issues. Why? It's because the power button, it's within the keyboard. So you should be very careful when diagnosing these machines. You should be very, 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 very careful when diagnosing these machines. Okay. Anyway, before I go, press the subscribe button and stay tuned. Love you all, guys.